Hey guys, welcome to another puzzle video. This is Nandhini. Most of y'all already know the drill. There'll be two puzzles today. The answer to the first puzzle we will be discussing right away, while the answer to the second puzzle is for y'all to post in the comment section below, and I will be pinning to the top the most precise answer so that everybody solving this puzzle could check their answers with yours. Getting back to the puzzle, this is white to play and win the game. This position was composed in the year 1990 by a player named Kalinin A. So please pause the video, try to find the answer and then resume it so you can confirm your answer with me. Getting to the answer now. We do notice that the black king is pretty close to our pawns, our passed pawns. I mean, these are the only pass pawns we have hope from because they are quite advanced. And the d2 pawn, we really have no hope from it because it's on the second rank and way too far behind. So the black king is pretty close. That's not a good thing for us. And he's even got a knight. And the knight and king could possibly try to capture the pawns and black could possibly get a draw. But this is white to play, as we know. So there is something that we can do to actually not allow black to get a draw and we can win the game. Now, what do we do? First of all, the pawn which I called useless some time ago, we first make use of it and we play the move d4 check, forking the king and the knight. After which, black is forced to capture king into d4, and now we have our pawns flying to their queening squares. So pawn g6, and now g7 is a serious threat, so knight e6 is again pretty forced. And now the move h5, because now we want to go h6 and then g7. So king e5, getting the king, he really doesn't have any other option, because even if he tries to play knight g7, we just go h6 and we gain a tempo and we push our pawn, so it doesn't really help black. So let's say king e5, and here we have to play the move g7, sacrificing our most advanced pawn. And after knight into g7, again knight into g7 is pretty forced. It is forced, in fact, because there's g8 queen on the next move. So after knight into g7, we push the last pawn in which we have all our hope in, so that is h6. And now if black does move the knight anywhere, we can just push the pawn and queen on the next move, so that is not possible. So the only hope now black has is playing the move king f6 and now hoping for white to capture the knight, because if white does capture the knight, then he gets king into pawn and he gets a draw. That's the best result he could get. But we are not going to capture the knight and we were going to simply push the pawn to h7. And now the pawn's queening and it cannot be stopped. So this was the answer to the first puzzle. And yes, please note that there was just one answer to this puzzle. So any other move would lead to a draw. There's just one variation and that I have discussed. Now let's go to the puzzle number two. So this is puzzle number two and this is white to play and win the game. And it is composed by L Pro Keys. And yes, please do post your answers in the comment section below. I've already mentioned that I will be pinning to the top the most precise answer. And please don't mind, but we are a new channel, so I got to ask you for something. If you did like this video, then please support us by liking this video. And how do you like the video? Well, there's a small thumbs up button right below the video, so please click on it. It's going to really help us a lot. And also, do not forget to subscribe to our channel if you do not want to miss more of our videos. Now again, the subscribe button is in red color, so you'll get that on the right hand side of this video. That's a shortcut to subscribe to our channel, while you could also visit our channel and check out the different variety of videos we have. All of them are really instructive, so please do check them out. Thank you. I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.